Hello, everyone, and welcome to tonight's LCTV Sports telecast of Littleton Tiger football. I'm Mike Fontenelle along with Pat Fredrickson. We are on the road tonight here in Maynard, where the Littleton Tigers at 2-0 will face off against their Tiger counterparts. Maynard also at 2-0, Patrick.
Yeah, I think this will be a bellwether game for them. Both these teams are 2-0. I don't think the competition that they've played so far has been that good. So this will be a really true measure, I think, for Littleton and for Maynard to see what they're made of this year.
Yeah, I think it'll go a long way towards determining seeding for the playoffs. I think both these teams are favorites to both make the playoffs, but this game could go a long way to determining who gets home field advantage. And Littleton will kick off, a good drive down to the 10-15 yard line. Eric Walker back kicking after being out last week. Oh, good stick up the middle. He had a good run there, a good head of steam, but a big stick.
That'll be big to have Rocker back here tonight, both on kickoffs and as a linebacker as well.
Yeah, Chance Ramirez coming up and putting a pop there. Ball returned out to the 26-yard line, first and 10 for Maynard.
So early in the season, Mike, it definitely looks like both these teams are built a little bit similarly. I saw, you know, just looking at the stats, I haven't seen them play yet, but Maynard likes to run the ball a lot. They got, you know, a lot of those running back, two, three guys that are going to put up 40 or 50 yards a game.
Yeah, Maynard scored 77 points in the first two games, Littleton at 82, so they both have been prolific offensively. But you're right, Maynard has lived and died on the run for the last few years. They're very good at it. Oh, big stick there. Coming off the edge there was number 43, Mitch Bowden.
Ball handed off to number 25.
So good penetration there by the defensive line. Bowden coming off his defensive tackle position with a hit for a loss for about 2 yards. Will bring up second and 12.
That's good penetration there from the right side, Mike. And, you know, that'll be big. If you can keep Maynard into second and long, third and long, then it could be a long night for Maynard.
I talked to Coach Lynn. He said he thinks that Maynard has some good receivers. They haven't had to use them yet in the season because their running attack has been doing very well against the first two opponents, Blackstone Valley and Murdoch. Oh, good penetration there again. Great tackle on the edge there. Eric, Cam Shoemaker coming up and making that hit from the cornerback position. So right now, Littleton's got the number on the Maynard running game after two plays. They've driven him back. Losses on both plays will bring up third and about 15.
Another beautiful night, Mike.
Yeah, great night for football. And it's a great rivalry. Maynard and Littleton compete against each other and at a high level in all the sports. And it's a great Friday night look here for the two teams that are always in the mix in Central Mass. So there you go, pal. Like you said, third and long. This is the kind of thing that Littleton would like to see all night long. Let's see how Maynard counters this. Oh, fumbled snap. Oh, sack. Never really got set up the way he wanted and couldn't get his eyes downfield. Looks like that was Shoemaker again coming off the backside. So a terrific start for the defense. Three plays, three losses of yardage. That'll bring up fourth and 20, at least 20, maybe 21 or 22.
That's a good spot for Cam Shoemaker. He's a fast kid, so coming off the edge. I don't think anybody saw him coming in. He had a pretty uncontested run right to the quarterback there.
And Eric Rocker.
The Rocker and Rossa back to receive the punt. It's a good end-over-end kick. He's going to let it bounce. Rocker's going to field it on the bounce at about the 30-yard line, looking for a wall. It cuts it up the middle. A little return there. Going to get the ball up to the 34. So the Tigers will take over on offense in their first possession here after turning them back three and out in the first defensive possession.
Yeah, it's a good stop. You never want to let the receiving team get momentum in there. Three good stops there. I don't think they gained much yards on any of their plays. And three and out, we'll see what Littleton comes out with.
So Peter Koch is starting at center. Jake Kivlin is injured tonight and won't play. He's been playing both sides of the ball, center and linebacker. There's a handoff up the middle. Oh, good rush there. Sawyer Lanfer is coming out of that tailback position. Going to get about 6 yards.
Last game against North Middlesex, Sawyer accumulated quite a nice, quiet game.
You know, in both games, he doesn't get a lot of touches because they have a lot of depth and a lot of weapons, so they move the ball around a lot. But he's got to be averaging easy 5-6 yards a carry. Fake sweep, quarterback draw. Good penetration there by Maynard. Very short gain, about a yard. Ball just over the 40-yard line. But Maynard read that play. They had the jet sweep look going. It was a fake handoff and then a quarterback draw, but Maynard wasn't fooled. They were in the gap. Third and four. Ball on the the Littleton 41 yard.
From the Littleton 41.
Looking to throw. Ooh, broken up. Good job there. Rocker had his hands on the ball, and then Hunter Miller had his hands on the ball, but the defender stepped in and knocked it out. So it looks like the Tigers will go turn the ball right back over on three and out.
Yeah, good defense there, Mike. I'll tell you, though, it's a well-run route there, and if you look at where he was hit, he was a half yard past that first down mark. So good play call. I think everything was good there, and if they continue to play like that, it's going to be a good sign for Littleton.
Rocker back to punt. He angles it towards the sideline. It's going to go out of bounds at about the 30-yard line.
See where they marked that.
Right on the 30.
So yeah, nicely done.
Both teams defensively getting good starts, three and out. And the ball back to Maynard on their own 30-yard line.
Yeah, Mike, you were talking earlier about what a great rivalry this is, and it kind of goes even deeper than that, right? I think that the kids from Harvard, from Bromfield, used to play with the kids from Littleton. That relationship ended. Now the kids from Bromfield are down here playing for Maynard, right?
Yeah, it was a co-op program, and Bromfield did affiliate with Littleton for a while, but that waiver was not granted, and then they ended up Maynard. And I think Maynard actually needed it a little bit more because they had fewer players coming out. There's Maynard's first gain from scrimmage for positive yards, about a three-yard gain.
Mike Thornton on the carry, took up on the play.
Mike Thornton got about 3 yards, second and seven.
Second and eight for Maynard from their own 33.
A little crisscross there, fake the sweep and inside handoff. A little counter, well read by the Tigers. We got a short gain on that. It'll bring up third and five. So Maynard able to reverse the trend from the first series, Pat, where they were going backwards on every play, but they're still in a third and longer situation here.
Yeah, I like the fact that they came out and they gave it a different look when they came out that first series. They were in the spread offense for the first two plays and giving them a little different look here, a little tighter look. Now they come out spread.
Two receivers out to the left, one in the slot to the right. We're going to hand it off right up the gut, and he's stuffed right at the line of scrimmage. Great job there by Brady Hunt. And Jack Scaramucci in there, too, making a big pile there. Good job there by the Tiger defense, and that'll bring up fourth and four. So neither team has managed to grind out a first down yet. Big Jack Scaramucci held that line right there. Did his best Vince Wilfork imitation.
That was nice. I seem to recall we called both those kids' names a lot last game. And if you're Mike Lynn, you like to have those two run stuffers in there. Speed on the outside, big in the middle.
Good high kick. Rocker's going to let bounce. This one come backwards and be down on the 30-yard line. So in the opening series here, both teams kind of going back and forth. Haven't been able to get a first down, trading punts. We're at 5:07 to go. No score yet in the game here in the first quarter. Tigers will stay with their spread look. Shoemaker rolling out, looking downfield, checking off his receivers. He's going to get sacked. Held that ball a little bit too long that time, Pat.
Yeah, I think that's a situation there where you just got to throw that one out of bounds and, come back and take second down.
Yeah, you got to get that count in your head, 5-6, nothing. Just let it go to the sideline and just avoid the loss and take a neutral outcome. So that'll be a 5-yard loss, ball back to the 25, second 15.
How many times have we said, he's kept the ball and made a play out of it? We said, we're really glad that he kept the ball. So
Gonna roll back the other way, going down the middle of the field. Ball tipped, caught by Anthony Ross. No, they're gonna say he's down.
Good call by the ref.
Yeah.
Lefty got down and then pulled it out. Yep.
He was emphatic about that. That is about a 9-yard gain, so that'll bring up 3rd and 6.
Maybe not on this play, Mike, but at some point they're gonna take a crack at this matchup that's closest to us. Jackson Ellis down on the side.
Ooh, high snap, handoff. Sawyer Lanford's trying to cut it up. He's short of the first down. Interesting call. There was 6 yards to go. He needed maybe one more break, and he would have had it, but he's going to be about a yard short. The ball is on the 39-yard line. Let's see if Coach Lynn feels like he's in a gambling mood right now.
Boy, this is a tough place to go for
it. Yeah, they're subbing. They're going to bring the punt unit out. Thought maybe they might line up under the center and try to get a hard count, see if they can draw somebody offside, but... Oh, wait a minute. They might think about it. They're going, Jared Kolari's on the field. They're going to bring out the
power offense,
yep. The hammer here, and try and get this yard here. Big fourth down play by the Tigers.
They do go hard count here. There you go.
Oh, they had it. Delay a game. Take a delay a game penalty. Oh, that's unfortunate. Peter Coach just didn't pull the trigger.
You know, Mike, you called that one exactly right. Right, come in, do the hard count. If you don't get it, call a timeout.
Instead, we're going to get a delay game penalty. Back him up 5 yards, so now to clearly be a punt situation.
Matthew, Mike Lynn, you can only call the plays, right?
Yeah, it's tough. Peter's coming in here, subbing in. He hasn't played a lot of center and hasn't been getting the reps, so just wasn't really ready for that.
It's one of the advantages that Littleton has to come through the spread offense, and then you come in with that power offense, short yardage, and going forward, that's going to be a tremendous weapon, especially early when they're in their own and when they're on their own side of the field.
I think if they had been 10 yards farther up the field, 4th and 1 from midfield, they might have actually gone for it. But with this yardage, you decided not to. End over end kick. Oh, terrific bounce. Ball's fumbled, picked up on the 22-yard line. Oh, he's going to get a run here. Now he's up the middle. Good coverage pursuit by the Tigers. They missed a few tackles there, and he gets a return out to the 36-yard line. So about a 14-yard return from where he actually ended up fielding the ball. And again, Pat, so far no first downs. A very pitched defensive battle. We're going here through, coming up on 2:55 to go in the first quarter.
Yeah, this game's pretty much taking place between the 30-yard line.
Inside handoff.
Oh,
yards
nice
there for Maynard. Yep. 5 or 6 yards. See where they mark it. Actually, they're going to say his knee bounced down, so about a 4-yard gain, 2nd and 6.
I think that was Chance Ramirez on that tackle. If he doesn't make that one, he's got another 10 yards at least.
Yeah, I like that look. They bring the guy in motion, and then they look like they're going to sweep, and then it's an inside handoff to the guy that went in motion.
Definitely a different look than North Middlesex was given them last week.
Oh, Cam Shoemaker got a little bit too deep in the backfield that time, had the wrong angle. There's our first down. Ball out to just short, right on midfield. First down for Maynard. Cam Shoemaker took a little bit too shallow angle when he pursued that. It looked like they kind of made it like a counter sweep, and he thought it was going away from him, and he pursued a little bit at a tough angle, and then it got outside of him, and that let him get upfield. 1st and 10 with the ball right at midfield. Oh, good job by Chance Ramirez, and then Cam Shoemaker comes up supporting the run very well there.
Yeah, it looked like a little busted play.
I think Cam Shoemaker busted up. He just got some huge defensive penetration there and just made that play go a lot wider than they wanted it to go, and that gave Cam plenty of time to come up from that storm position to make the hit. No gain on the play, 2nd and 10, under a minute and a half to go here in the opening quarter. Maynard's going to call a timeout. The coach throws his headset off in disgust.
And I think if you're Mike Ling, you tell him to keep doing what you're doing here. If Littleton's in there, bend but don't break mode on this side of the field.
Yeah, I think that it looks like, looking at it from the press box here, Littleton's definitely got the advantage of size up front. And for the most part, they take advantage of that. They really aren't getting blown off the line of scrimmage. They're actually going into the backfield. It's just a couple of counter plays by Maynard. They've gotten a little bit of a seam to get some positive yards, and they managed to pick up their first down here on this drive. But overall, it's a good trend for the defensive line to control that line of scrimmage and make it hard to run that run-based offense. And when they get that kind of penetration, it just lets the cornerbacks and the storm linebackers get up the line of scrimmage, and you've got like, you know, 8-9 guys defending that box.
And as we see, you know, the key to all of that, right, you get the good penetration up the middle, and so you just want to be careful to not overplay.
Right.
If you come in from the edges and contain.
Right, the one first down they got was exactly that. Cam got a little aggressive, and he got burned by a little of a counter look. And if they just, you know, take the yards they can get in the backfield, but, you know, be ready for the counters, they should be all set. So second and 10 after the Maynard timeout. There's that inside handoff again. Stacked up Brady Hunt at the line of scrimmage. Tristan will leave in there on the hit two from his linebacker position, but it was definitely Brady that busted that up. Came off his block and made the hit right at the line of scrimmage. They're going to mark it about a yard gain, so it's third and 9. The ball in Littleton territory on the 49-yard line.
Bronco picks up about 2 yards, 38.
45 seconds to go here in the quarter. The clock running. We'll get at least one more play here in this quarter. Inside handoff, stacked up. Chance Ramirez there, linebacker. I feel like they're in four down territory though now, Pat. I mean, it's going to be fourth and about 6. No, they're going to bring out some subs. They're going to punt. Fourth and 6 with the ball on Littleton 47-yard line. The clock is running. They'll actually let the clock run out.
Maynard here feels like their defense has been doing a good job. And with a good punt here, maybe you pin the back inside the 20.
Yeah, try to win the battlefield position. So at the end of the first quarter, a defensive battle between two evenly matched Tiger teams. It's 0-0, and we'll be back with the second quarter action right after these messages from LCTV.
I see you mobbing over her. Let's go. Let's mob. Let's crawl. Let's crawl. Let's crawl. Hey yo, we mobbing. Come on, girl. Let's crawl. Hey yo, let's crawl. Hey yo, let's crawl. Hey, let's crawl. Hey yo, let's crawl.
Welcome back. Second quarter, Maynard facing a 4th and 6, punt formation. Ball on the Littleton 47-yard line. A high kick going towards the sideline, out of bounds. So they were trying to drive a deep pad. They're going to get the ball on about the 25-yard line. You said it, they've been playing between the 30s. So Maynard, I think, was hoping to get the ball down inside the 20, but went out of bounds at the 25-yard line.
Yeah, I actually like that call by Maynard. You know, you go for it there, you don't get it. You give Littleton field position on your side of the field. Get rid of the ball here. You know, if you do get off a good kick here, you get him down inside the 20, then things are even better. I think that both teams are feeling like they're really well disciplined here, and both teams are feeling like their defense can hold. So we'll see how it all turns out.
All right, so the Tigers, who have not yet to pick up a first down out of the spread look, are going to go hammer here in the to start the second quarter. Jared Kalari in a quarterback, Griffin Shoemaker and Tony Ross at the tailbacks. Ross up the middle, powering forward, going to get about a 5-yard gain on that.
You know, we did the game last week, and I was trying to figure out who Anthony reminded me of, and you know, came to my head one day. He reminds me of Matt Forte, who runs for the Jets. He kind of runs upright, doesn't look like he's really going 100%. And every, you know, 1-yard gains end up being 3-yard gains, and the 2-yard gains end up being 5-yard gains. And before you know it, he's in the end zone. Quick feet, I think, is one of his big things.
Yeah. He does a good job of cutting it up and getting the hole. All the backs in this offense are trained to do that, get in that first gap and just power forward and, you know, make your first 5 yards. And the coaches always say, you owe me the first 5 yards are mine. They're in the gap. After that, you can have what you want. You can get, you know, cut it to the outside, start dancing, whatever you want, but you owe me the first five. All right, second and five. Coming back to Shoemaker, the other side. He's going to get stacked up in the line of scrimmage. Very short game. That will bring up third and five.
Be interesting to see how this hammer works for Littleton tonight. It's, you know, Maynard to me looks a little bit bigger on that front line, a little bit better penetration. So
they're definitely bigger than the opponents that they face in the first two games when they played Tingsboro and North Middlesex. Let's see here. They can throw out of this formation. It's third and five.
No, I was just thinking the same thing, Mike, that, you know, Mike Lynn has some other looks that we haven't necessarily seen yet this year coming out of the hammer.
Inside handoff. Oh, oh, the ball's out. Whoa. We got a big first down there. That was Griffin Shoemaker. He kind of got hit, and he was, kept his feet moving and slipped out of the tackle and broke up field. And as he broke up, the ball bubbled right out of his hands. He almost got the cherry bounce that he wanted, which would have been a race to the end zone at that point. But then he just did his best job just falling on it.
Yeah, the instinct is to try to pick that thing up and run it on the fly, but falling out on a midfield is probably a good choice there.
Yeah, the first Tiger first down into Maynard territory, ball on the 48-yard line, first and 10, staying in the hammer. Now they're going to throw out of it. Oh, he's got him. Mitch Corey racing downfield. Oh, he couldn't quite get it. Took a little while for Kalari to set his feet. Mitch came moving. He was open right away. And Jared had to set his feet. By the time he did, he just overthrew it a little bit.
You know, down the road, that's going to be a killer play. The two things that I saw were exactly what you said. So he was open right away. And then I think Mitch broke off his route a little bit, expected the ball to come right away. And it was just that little bit off timing there.
He did. He slowed up his route a little bit. If he kept running full stretch, it might have been a big completion. Second and 10 after the incomplete pass. Crisscross, Anthony Rosser running up the gut. Going to get a good 7-8 yard gain out of that. That'll bring up third and about four. The ball is on the 43-yard line. They need to get to about the 39-yard line to pick up a first down here. I'm feeling like this is four-down territory, Pat.
Yeah, you got to get something going here. And again, if you have confidence in your defense, why not, right?
You know, they should hopefully get some positive yardage here. So if they don't pick up the first down, they should be in a short yardage situation. And the ball is down inside Maynard territory. So let's see what happens here on third down. Shoemaker to the left. He's going to get a first down and more. That's the second time he came sliding out of that after getting a little bit of contact. He just keeps his feet moving. He almost popped that one. I feel like it's just a matter of time right now. This power offense looking real good for the Tigers. This is their best drive, obviously. They picked up a couple of first downs, driven the ball to the Maynard 29-yard line.
The other thing about this offense, Mike, is because you're running the ball so much, you're going to keep the Maynard defense on the field a little bit more. And like last week, you want to kind of stretch them out, get them tired, keep them on the field.
Ross in motion, inside handoff to Sawyer Lanfers. Oh, he just got caught at the last second before he got his feet moving. He's going to get about a yard gain on that.
One of the things that makes this look so tough, Mike, is the guys in the backfield that aren't getting the ball, they're so good at the fake motion. So back here, when Griffin almost broke the other one and he dropped the ball at midfield and picked it up again, Anthony Rosser put an unbelievable fake on in the backfield, making the pitch coming to him.
Yeah, and, he did. They sell it really good, and Jared Kalari is very good at that quarterback position, making it look like it's going to go one way and then countering back the other. So second and nine. Rosser back in motion again. This time they are going to get the sweep. Gets to the outside. Brady Hunt gets a little brush block. Good trade. Good job there by the Maynard defense.
I think if Anthony gets that edge, he's going to
get Ryan McCormick did a nice job of eluding Brady Hunt's block. It's a long way for the big guy to get out there and get an angle to make a block. He almost did it, but McCormick did a nice job of coming off it. So now they're going to go spread here, facing third and long. They'll bring the passing unit out. Shoemaker back at quarterback. Got Miller and Rosser to his right. Oh, they're going to go counter handoff. Rosser looking to throw. Trying not to take a loss here, but he is going to take a huge loss. Ooh, he's down there. Ball back over midfield. Try to go deep in the playbook there. He just couldn't get rid of the ball. Well, that's unfortunate. That's going to be a 16-yard loss. But that'll bring up. They had a nice drive going, and now this is not four down territory at all.
Yeah, there's not much to say about that play, Mike, except it was really well defended. I think it was drawn up well. I think they executed, and Maynard just stayed home.
So the Maynard defense turns back the first legitimate threat by Littleton. Good kick here by Mitch Corey, drives it back down to the 10-yard line. Six-yard return, eight-yard turn, back ball out to the 18-yard line. So we talked about it. That was a good punt. This time they do get some good field position, but they're feeling like they left a good chance out there.
Yeah, a couple of plays there. Griffin almost broke a couple of them. I think they're close. They're definitely close.
See if the defense can do their job and get the ball right back here so they can try and get back and get that offense going again. First and 10 with the ball on the 18-yard line. Oh, inside handoff, big first down there for Maynard. So they got some good looks back there too, where they're sending guys in motion and looking one way and then sending it the other.
Yeah, they've had some good success in that quick hit up right up the middle.
It's good for a 12-yard gain. The ball out just over the 30-yard line. First down for Maynard. Side again. Oh, big gap there. Oh, he's tripped up. He's all knocked down. Oh, well inside lot, Littleton territory. So right now, two big plays by Maynard. They come all the way out from their own 18-yard line down to the Tiger 36-yard line, first and 10.
That was a great one by P.J. Falzone. And that was the same play that came back with the quick kick right up the middle.
Yeah, Falzone had over 100 yards rushing last week in a big win against Murdoch. So Maynard counters after the Tigers get their best drive going. Maynard comes back with their best drive. Two quick first downs. Ball inside Littleton territory, 36-yard line, first and 10. They're going to go right back to the inside again. They get another 5-yard gain. They're just going with those inside handoffs, trying to run between the tackles, and they're doing a good job. 4 minutes and 25 seconds to go here in the first half.
And even some of the linebackers step up and plug those holes, make them run to the edges.
Second and 5.
Tigers will have it on the 32-yard line.
Inside again. Another game, but short of the first down. Ball inside the 30-yard line.
You're definitely in two down territory here, Mike.
Yeah, third and about two. Mark third and 3. So Maynard's definitely found something they like, that inside look. Very effective on this drive. Let's see if Carlo Ferrante counters back with some blitzes or stunts. Oh, motion there. Ooh, that's a tough mistake to make. False start on Maynard. Back him up 5 yards, make it 3rd and 8.
I'm not sure if I jinx these guys in my head, but I was just thinking that this is such an enjoyable game so far and a well-played game. And the only penalty up to this point has been to delay a game on
right.
Littleton when they're trying to draw him offside.
Yeah. Let's see if that changes the play call for Maynard. I still think I feel very much so. They're in four down territory, so they got two shots to convert this. Littleton's going to have to come up big on two plays. Let's see if they can start here on third down. Inside handoff again. This time that's stacked up for a very short game. But you can see how, Pat, you know, those plays are great when you get the blocking up front, because you got to make it look like it's a sweep, and then it's the inside handoff. So it's a slow developing deep play. And if you can get that penetration, you can stack it up. 4th and 7, all on the 33-yard line, under 2.5 minutes to go here in the quarter. Big down here for Littleton. Try to get the ball back here and get out of the half. No worse than tied.
Yeah, if you're Maynard, you're going to probably pull something out of your playbook here, a little counter, a little misdirection.
Keep it on the ground. It's a straight run. He's going to get a first down. Great cut there by Maynard. By the running back, yeah. Perfect cut there. He read it perfect. A big first down. Ball out to the 20-yard line. Big fourth down conversion.
Good job of him reading that last tackler, too, to just get enough to get over that first down marker.
Yeah, foul zone. Good running back there. He made it. Made a great play. Showed how good he is there. First and 10 from the 20-yard line. With under 2 minutes to go here in the quarter. Inside again. Oh, he missed him. And he gets to the outside. They miss him again. Oh, great effort there. And he's going to score. Wow. Yeah, Pat, that was at least three or four missed tackles there. Big touchdown by Alex Longo for Maynard on a 20-yard run. He got hit 4 or 5 times and just refused to go down. And finally stumbles across the goal line with the first score of the game.
Yeah, he just kept his feet bumping. If you watch how fast his feet were moving, he just kept them going. Every time he got hit, he kept them moving. Sure there, Mike. It looked like he might have fumbled that ball going across the goal line.
And then recovered it in the end zone. I think if you fumble it, you can recover it. Maynard's going to try and kick the point. They drive it through the uprights. Yes? No, it's no, wide.
Left.
All right, 6-0 Tigers with 1.5 minutes to go. So Littleton, for the first time all season, finds themselves trailing in a game. They struggled offensively to get something going. They had a good drive going last time, but they took a big loss on a third down play. Be interesting to see here, Pat. You got nothing to lose here with 1.5 minutes to go. Let's see if they decide. They really haven't gone downfield yet. You said it. They've got, you know, Jackson Ellis, a big athletic target on one side, and Hunter Miller on the other side. Let's see if they decide to try to pick on those matchups and see what they can get out of it.
Yeah, the other thing they might try to do here, Mike, too, is get some of the other faster receivers out here, get them on slant routes, right? Get them 5 yards down the field and let them run. 1:30 for Littleton. I kind of like this. It's going to loosen them up. Like you said, nothing to lose. Get the ball back here. Let's really just try to run our offense and let it go and see what we got. I think they'll come out in the spread and they'll try to score here.
They're also going to get the ball to start the second half. So what would be terrific is to see if they can make a couple of big plays and get a score before the half and take that momentum, that taste of the momentum away from Maynard, and then come back in the second half and get a score and get that the momentum back where we want it on the Littleton side of the field. Oh, it's a high kick. Fair. Good job. Excellent job there by Cam Shoemaker, signaling fair catch. All right, so that ball will be on the 36-yard line. Still 1.5 minutes to go. Plenty of minutes. I think Littleton has all their timeouts.
Yeah, I mean, coming out of here, I'd be thinking Hunter Miller is a prime target. We haven't called his name yet. He's got a great set of hands, run some really good routes.
The Tigers in the spread look. Now they're going to run. Sawyer Lanfers gets a run on the sideline. Tackle after about a 7-yard gain from behind.
Get out of bounds.
Mike Lynn's going to call a timeout, so with 1:20 to go. 2nd and about 3. Oh, So it's the first time out for Littleton, plenty left. So that was interesting, Pat, there in the spread look, and caught Maynard maybe a little bit thinking pass, and they got a good run, Sawyer got into the defensive backfield. Good 7 yard gain.
Yeah, you like to chew off 7 to 10 yards on that one, but you definitely want to get out of bounds if you can. Keep that time, keep your timeouts where you get.
Yeah, he got run down from behind. I don't think he knew the guy was coming, so he didn't have a chance to really make that read. All right, so a minute 20 seconds to go here in the half. Tigers trailing 6-0. Second and three with the ball on the Littleton 44-yard line. Got three receivers out to the left. Inside handoff again to Sawyer. He's trying to cut it up. It's going to be just short of a first down. Clock's going to continue. Littleton's going to take another timeout here. So third and short. Still haven't thrown the ball yet, though, Pat.
Yeah, interesting here, right? So you're going to try to run the ball here. You know, you don't want to get the ball back to Maynard at this point if you can avoid it. But at the same time, you know, put the ball in the air on third down is a little more dangerous than first and second down. Let's see what he does here.
Yeah, you know, you're right. The thing is, if you throw on first and second down, it's incomplete. You're putting yourself in a third and long situation. And then, you know, calling timeouts, you're right. You might give the Maynard the ball back with some time on the clock. Let's see if they try to convert the first down here and take their first shot downfield.
Shoemaker keeps it.
Yeah, and he didn't get the first down there. He was trying to make a kind of a that read option play with Sawyer. Fourth and one, under a minute to go. Right now the clock's running. Mike Lynn is not going to call a timeout here.
Why is Maynard not calling a timeout? Right, if you're Maynard, you bring your timeouts and get the ball back, right?
Yeah. I think what Coach Lynn's going to do is he's going to let this play clock run down, and then he's going to call a timeout. And then he'll decide if he wants to punt away on fourth down or just take a long throw downfield. Yeah, he's just letting the play clock run down. He's going to wait and call a timeout here.
So just out of curiosity, Mike, what are your thoughts? Because if you're Maynard, when I looked at the clock, there was 103 left on the clock, one play left, right? Call a timeout with a minute left. Force them into either going for it on fourth down or punting the ball.
Yeah, I agree with you. I would have called a timeout for sure and make them make a tough decision. Even if you give up the first down, you probably got a better than your average odds of not letting them score. And if you hold them, then, you know, you've got a shot to go for it. And even if on a punt, you know, you get a good return, you get the ball to your 30 or 40 yard line, you know, you can take a couple shots downfield too, right? But that's why I hesitate to say this, but maybe that's why Mike Lynn's the Belichick of the Mid-Wachusett D Conference. All right, so they are going to come out in punt formation here. Mitch Corey back to punt. Maynard is taking no chances. They have no one back to receive the punt.
Keep this one in play.
Yep, just going to drive it down the middle of the field. Going to check up around the 10-yard line. Just going to stop on the 11-yard line. Going to be down with 12 seconds to go on the clock here. So interesting there. They didn't really take their shot downfield. They were content to run the ball, and then when they got stymied, they just punted it away. And they will go into the half, in all likelihood, trailing by 6.
Yeah, maybe he's just thinking he wants to get to halftime, get him resettled. You know, I think they're playing fairly well, but maybe Mike sees something that he wants to talk about at halftime.
Yeah.
Wants to go into the locker room down 6-0 rather than down, you know, 12-0, 14-0.
Yeah, on that last drive, they definitely got to fix that inside handoff problem. Maynard was very good at it, and then that one run was just a terrific effort by Longo and some missed tackles by Littleton. Maynard's just going to take a snap in the half here. So, at the end of the first half of this very good defensive battle, the Littleton Tigers give up one score and trail for the first time all year, down 6-0. And we'll go to halftime, see if they can fix it, and come back and start the second half with the ball. We'll be right back with second half action after these messages on LCTV.
You're not f***ing it. Every day, kids witness bullying.
Why are you stabbing me with it?
No.
They want to help, but don't know how. Teach your kids how to be more than a bystander. Visit stopbullying.gov.
Welcome back, everyone. Second half action, Littleton Tiger High School football. The Tigers trailing 6-0 against Maynard. As we await the second half kickoff here, they're starting a little earlier than they thought they were going to, so they're going to set the scoreboard and get the kicker out there and get ready for second half action. Nice of you to join me, Patrick.
I had a thing.
All right, so here we go. Tigers trailing for the first time all year. 6-0, just down one score. Another high kick. Going to field it on the 25-yard line. Oh, it burst up the middle. And he's wrapped up on the 40-yard line, 15-yard return.
Covers by Maynard. About 22 minutes to get back and get the lead here, Mike.
Bradley Clark on the return there. Yeah, they off to a little bit of a slow start in the first quarter, and then they kind of got some momentum going. And they had a drive going. They got the ball down to about the Tiger Maynard 30-yard line, but then took a loss on a kind of a trick play. And that was really the best offense they had. Here they go, Hammer here to start the second half. Pretty Rossa up the middle. Driving, good game there, about a 6-yard gain out over the 45-yard line. You can see it again, Pat, it was just like one high step away from popping that one.
Right, you know, and again, you know, to me, I'm looking at that play, it looks like Maynard had it well defended, and, you know, you're done, and Anthony's picked up 6 yards.
You know, we talked about how Griff Shoemaker had a big run, and the ball slipped out, and he couldn't quite corral it. If he had, he would have had a touchdown. Now that's looming a little larger here as they trail 6-0. Counter back. Oh, they got the edge.
Nice play.
Eric Rocker that time got a good job, made a good read there, saw the edge and ran to the sideline. Ball into Maynard territory down to the 40-yard line. So the Tigers off to a quick start here. Actually, they put it on the 38-yard line, excuse me, the 42-yard line, so they slipped out of bounds. So Rocker playing tailback. He's not really in that look too much. Some of the guys that take some reps there, Kevin Frizzoli is injured tonight, so he's not going to play there. Rocker's back out at tailback. He was out last week, but he's ready to play this week and got a big gain on that play. Inside handoff to Rocker again. He's trying to drive for the sideline. Got about 3 or 4 yards there.
I'll send it here in the box. Mike, we got a really good look at how that counter works, that misdirection, looking this way, inside hand off to Rocker. Tough to defend. A lot of moving parts.
So that'll bring up 2nd and 6 with the ball on the Maynard 38-yard line. Oh, flag goes down. Gloss is going to get hit for a loss on that, but looks like what we got here.
Maynard offside, I guess.
Yeah, I would think, because if it was... No, I think it might be an illegal formation on Littleton. Well, it's hard. It's not, that's a pretty vanilla formation. I don't know how they would line up. Oh, offside. You're right, Pat.
Yeah, the left edge here was trying to get a jump. He's been doing a good job here, 54. And he's got a little too quick with his feet that time.
Maybe that's why he made the play. But that's big because Anthony Rossa took a loss there. But, yeah, for the line of scrimmage to walk off 5 yards. So instead of having 3rd and 10, they're going to have 2nd down over again with about a yard to go here. And actually, we'll call it 2 yards. So 2nd and 2 after the Maynard penalty. See if the Tigers can capitalize on that mistake.
Been all positive yards on this drive. I would just stick to what you're doing.
Ross in motion, inside handoff, first down, trying to hold on to the football. Got Sawyer Landfers there. Yep, gets a first down to the 25, 26-yard line.
Keep your feet moving. Yep. Sawyer did a good job there. You got turned around and just kept pushing backwards.
Sawyer running behind that big line. Peter Coaches, Brady Hunt, Chance Ramirez blocking up front, and they get a good first down there, ball on the 25-yard line. Deepest scoring drive so far for Littleton. Rocker again, gonna cut it up, driving forward, gonna get a very short gain, about 2 yards. Couldn't get the edge that time, had to cut it up, and good pursuit by the Maynard defense down the line of scrimmage.
Mike, I think the biggest problem tonight is they keep running the ball and this game's going so fast, and I don't actually have anything else to do on a Friday night.
You know what's interesting, Pat, is that the Cam Shoemaker has not taken any reps here in this set at tailback. I'm wondering if there's, I see him on the sideline, he looks okay.
Yeah, I don't remember taking any big hits.
Yeah, exactly. Well, so we'll see what happens as the half unfolds. Second and 8. They're going to roll out for Kalari. Looking down the line of scrimmage. Oh, great catch by Mitch Crory. Yes, they're going to give him the catch on the 12-yard line. Wow, that was close, Pat. Kalari was rolling to his right, and there was a lot of pressure coming from the backside that he didn't really know was coming, but he managed to get the ball away, and Crory made a great diving catch. The ball's down to the 7-yard line. First and goal for Littleton.
It looked to me, too, like that defender that got just a little bit piece of Jared right as he was throwing that, so that was a great job of getting that ball off. That was big traffic coming behind him. Good job, Jared.
Pitch to Rocker. Oh, great block on the corner. Anthony Ross with a terrific block to give Rocker the corner, and he gets down inside the 5-yard line. What a block. Second and goal from the 5-yard line. Under 7 minutes to go here in the third quarter. Tigers trailing 6-0, trying to get the tying score here. By far the best offensive possession of the game.
Best pal, Ethan. How you doing? You're not Ethan.
Staying with the hammer here.
I see Sawyer punch one in here.
Gonna go pitch to Rossa, driving forward. Oh, he's very close to the goal line, down to about the 2-yard line.
Third down.
Nothing fancy about that. He just hit that a gap, running behind Chance Ramirez, was pulling from the left side.
Sawyer out in front as well.
Yeah, positive yards and knocking on the door. Ball right on the about the 1-yard line here. Third down. Tristan Lee lined up at fullback. Rocker and Ross at the tailbacks. We'll go back to Ross. Oh, big hit there in the backfield. He almost got out of it. Couldn't quite do it. That'll bring up fourth down.
They might have lost a yard or two here, Mike.
Maynard was thinking that the ball got stripped out of there. They think they want possession of the ball, but they're not going to get the call. That'll bring in the ball up to about the 3-yard line. Fourth and goal.
Big play here, big play.
Coach Lynn's going to call a timeout here.
We're going to call a timeout.
Bring the whole team to the sideline here. Think about how the play call they want to get off and the blocking scheme they want to execute here. Big, big down here in this ball game.
Yeah, this is a big down for the year too, Mike. It's good to see Littleton in a tough game like this. This is just going to go a long way to finishing up the season. As we said in our last game, you want these guys to go deep into the playoffs. But this is a good test. This is where you have to produce. This is where you have to execute. And part of this, too, is what Mike's going to have up his sleeve here. You know, he's staying with the same offense here. Is he going to try to power this one right up the middle, or is he got something else that he runs at the goal line? I like the timeout, whatever he's going to call here.
Now, obviously, if they don't convert, they'll have Maynard pinned deep. So, it's not like they can't turn this into an advantage. But they've really struggled to get something going offensively. If they get turned away without a score here, no matter how you try to spin it, it'll be a disappointment for them. It's been a terrific drive, a lot of great plays. And they just want to try to cap it right here with one big play from the 3-yard line and just punch it in.
Yeah, they've already chewed off 5.5 minutes of the clock.
All right, from the 3-yard line, the lineup in the hammer.
I got right behind Brady Hunt here.
Sawyer Lambert in the fullback, Rocker and Rossa. They're going to Rocker. He hurdles it, drives forward.
I don't see him.
Touchdown, Tigers! Touchdown, Tigers. The senior coming in to play some reps at tailback, coming off an injury last week. He hurdles the pile and stumbles forward and just breaks the plane. The Tigers will tie it up 6-6 here with 5:29 to go in the third quarter. Huge play by the senior.
That was a late call, so it must have been close.
Yeah.
And this is right here. This is where you can really get the momentum going here. You punch this one in now, you actually take the lead.
Going for two. They're going to go all fumbled. Oh, they're trying to go crisscross there, and they just couldn't quite get the second hand off, and they're turned away. So it is 6-6.
That's one solid drive by Littleton, Mike.
Yeah, you know, Eric Rocker hasn't been playing that tailback position in the hammer, and they went to give that kind of, they flip him the ball, and he's supposed to hand it back, and he just didn't quite get the handle on it. Again, questioning why Griffin Shoemaker didn't get any reps at tailback there. We'll see what happens if he plays any on the defensive side of the ball this possession. A solid drive to open the half. They've got some good momentum there, Patrick. Let's see if the defense can respond and get him the ball right back.
Yeah, I think. Yeah, Mike, I think you were talking about Cam Shoemaker earlier, but I think you were referring to Griffin.
Yeah,
right?
Sorry. Yeah, Griffin Shoemaker, yeah.
I see Cam out there now.
Yeah.
Every play on that last drive, except for the one, I think, was positive yards for Littleton. So that's, again, quite a drive.
Yeah, they're relying on that offensive line. Been playing very well in the first two games, and they really asserted themselves on that drive. So, just a leave kicking here. Oh, good end-over-end kick. Feel it on the 20-yard line. Oh, Mitch Corey, great job there, shooting the gap and getting a good hit there after a 12-yard return by Maynard. Ball out to the 32-yard line, 33-yard line.
On a drive kick like that, that's actually pretty good coverage right
there. Yeah, very good. They did a good job. Mitch saw the lane that he had and just exploded in and made a good hit there. So the Tiger offense, the opening possession, a long drive, over five and a half minutes, ends up in a score to tie the game at 6. And the defense coming out for their first possession in the second half. Tommy Keene and Brady Hunt, and Mitch Bowden, the defensive line. Counter inside handoff. Oh, burst up the middle. Good 7-yard gain. That was their go-to look in the first half that gave Maynard their score.
Yeah, and all they're doing, Mike, is they're taking the slot receiver and they're running him like it's going to be a reverse and then pushing him right back up through the middle.
And they're sealing it off real good. He's taking the ball. It's a deep handoff. But he's taking it with a full sprint towards the line of scrimmage and then just racing up the field. It's a 9-yard gain, second and one. First down after a short gain, ball out over the 45-yard line. A 3-yard gain. First down, Maynard. On their own 46-yard line.
Chances plugging up a pretty good game here on defense. On the blue ticket, 6-5-0-4-4-5-4.
Oh, false start there in the backfield by Maynard. After picking up a first down, first and 10. They'll take a 5-yard penalty for a false start. First and 15 on the ball on the Maynard 41-yard line. You know, when you're a power running team, those kinds of penalties make it harder to grind those first downs out. Let's see if Littleton can take advantage here of the mistake by Maynard. Inside handoff again. Oh, good job there. Brady Hunt coming off his block. tripping the ball carrier up. Actually, going to take a loss there of about a yard.
Tristan will leave getting in there, too, and it looks like they're trying to stack the box here, Mike, get the linebackers to shoot the gas before they can get under a head of steam.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking earlier. It's just that, you know, those plays, those inside handoffs, you know, they're deep in the backfield. The defensive linemen got to find the football and get off their blockers and try to make, if you don't make the tackle, at least make them push the run out towards the sideline. A sub into the defensive line there. Mitch Bowden at nose tackle. Hunter Miller at defensive tackle. Casey Romley at the other tackle. Oh, good rush there. Gonna get about a 5 yard gain and he's stacked up. But there we go. After we talk about the penalty there, that'll bring up a 3rd and 10. Actually, 11. So even though they got a 5 yard gain, all they really did was get the penalty yardage back. After getting stuffed on first down in the previous play, they're facing a 3rd and long here with the ball on their own 45 yard line. Big down here for Littleton. They can get a stop here, Pat. They'll probably force a punt and get the ball back.
Yeah, I'd be curious to see if they pass the ball here, Mike. We haven't seen them, and they have the ability to chew up big chunks of yardage running the ball. So I actually would think they're going to keep the ball on the ground here.
Well, they're going to throw, rolling them out. Looking downfield, a high throw. Rosser turns back. Oh! Oh, he missed it. He had it for a second. But he couldn't quite reel it in. Incomplete pass. Rosser did a nice job of finding the football there. Because there was a little bit of bumping and contact going on, but because he saw the football, the ref gave him the benefit of the doubt. Good coverage there by the senior playing defensive back. 4th and 11. So the Tiger defense holds on the first possession by Maynard and forces a punt.
Up here, it looks like he grabbed that at first, Mike, on the far side of the field.
I think he had it, but as he was going down to the ground, he just couldn't quite hang on to it, and it came loose and went out of bounds.
Nice throw there by the quarterback.
All right, here we go. Punt formation. Oh, almost blocked. Oh, a nice high kick. Ross is going to let it bounce, and it's going to go towards the middle of the field and down on about the 17-yard line. So Maynard picks up a first down and a terrific punt. The Tigers will start deep in their own territory. But tie game, Pat. The defense comes up and gets the ball back, and they did their job. Let's see if the offense can come out with another good drive here with 2 minutes and 15 seconds to go.
Mike, it's starting to rain here. That's going to definitely affect the game plan. We were talking earlier last week when it starts to get this time of night, the ball gets slick, the field gets slick, and now a little bit of a drizzle here, so interesting to see what these teams do.
Tigers scored with their hammer look on the last possession. They're going to stay with it here. Oh, fumbled snap. Oh, it's picked up by Maynard. Oh, what a turn of events. A fumbled snap, not recovered. And not only is it not recovered by Littleton, but Maynard picks it up and rushes it into the end zone. So just like that, they get back on top of Littleton. Nat DuPlice on the right spot at the right time, makes a clean pick of the ball, fields it off the ground, and just a short jaunt to the end zone. Oh, tough break there. First turnover by the Tigers, I think, all year.
And that ball hit the ground, and it didn't seem like there were any Littleton kids around. I think it just kind of fooled everybody there. That's unfortunate.
Oh, block kick. You got to cover this up. You can run this upfield. If they get all the way to the end zone, you get a get tripped up. So Maynard 0 for 2 on conversions, but they have the lead after a big play. Turnover by Littleton is a scoring play. You know, Pat, Maynard has 2 pick sixes in each of the first 2 games, and now they've got a fumble return for a touchdown. So their defense is contributing on the scoreboard again tonight, 12-6, Maynard. 2:08 to go in the third quarter.
Mike, I didn't see who got in and blocked that extra point. Was that Rocker?
Might have been. I couldn't quite see it. It was down the far end of the field here. Yeah, you're right. The rain coming down a little more heavily here. Let's see if the Tigers can pick themselves up after making a mistake. Like you talked about it, Pat, you know, at some point during the season, you know, you got to be prepared to deal with adversity, and sometimes how you deal with that will determine how the season turns out.
Right.
You know, is it going to be a good season or a great season will often be determined by how you manage adversity. And This is the first time after two easy wins in the first two games, they're trailing again for the second time this game.
We've seen time and time again, like, when you get into a tight contest, it really comes down to who executes. And, you know, this is just, I mean, it's just one play for sure, but you can see the impact of just one play against a quality team.
Ball's going to go out of bounds. Good job by Sawyer Lanfers to let that happen. See what the Littleton decides to do. They can re-kick, or I believe it's five-yard penalty, and they're going to make them re-kick. The ball went out of bounds on about the 23-yard line, so if they took the penalty yardage, it'd only be on the 28. It's actually pretty decent in high school football if you keep the other team beyond the 30-yard line on the kick return. So they'll back them up 5 yards and make them re-kick.
I like this call. I think they're going to try to get something going here. Apparently, Mark Corey's up on the top of the press box complaining about the weather, but Mike, I'm fine. How about you?
I feel great.
Hey, Mike, we should probably turn down the heat in here. I'm getting a little warm.
Here we go. Another high kick. Fielded by Clock again. Gets a run. Going to get the hold on that football. A good job there. Gets out to the 44-yard line. So
big difference between that and the 28.
Yeah, 16 yards of real estate they picked up there. So good field position for Littleton. 2:03 to go in the third quarter. Trailing by 6.
And I still don't see Griffin Shoemaker coming out of the third quarter. Yeah, let's see.
Yeah. So the Tigers stay with the hammer look. Pitch to Rossa. He's going to be trot down after no gain at all. Eric Kiley, number 84 on the tackle there.
When I did the basketball games and you were on the sideline with Coach Lombard, I had a chance to call Eric Kiley's name a couple times last year. Good athlete.
No gain on the play. Second and 10. Ball still on the Littleton 45-yard line.
You know, Mike, you talk about adversity too, right? So if Griffin's out of the game, anchored down, I mean, this is a good learning experience here. See what they have.
He's going to cut, try to bounce it outside. He's going to get tackled. No gain there. So Maynard, after giving up the scoring drive on the first possession of the second half, the Tigers put together a great drive out of that hammer look. Maynard has countered back and has two stops here on the first two downs of this series. And Mike Lynn is going to take a timeout with 1:06 to go in the third quarter, third and long. It's tough now because if Griffin Shoemaker is indeed out of the ball game, it's like I don't know that he can come back to the spread, and certainly not with the same level of confidence. I'm not sure who the backup quarterback is for that spread look.
Yeah, that's a good point. You know, Jared could definitely handle the hammer offense as well, and we see Jared make a nice pass earlier. So we'll see if Mike has to put the ball in the air here a little bit, let Jared go. After that, I know Kevin Fazzoli plays the quarterback, right?
Yeah, he's out tonight, too. He's not dressed. Mitch Corey's been a quarterback before.
You know, you mentioned earlier that Mike Lynn's the Belichick of the Wachusett League, so I think he's trying to get down to his fourth or fifth string quarterback here.
Yeah, right. If Belichick can do it, so I got to try and see what I can do. It's not that Griffin can't play. I just want to see what we can do here.
Yeah, I'd like to see Brady.
There he is. He's back in the ball game. So he is okay. So at least okay enough to play in the spread. So the go spread here, third and 10. Griffin Shoemaker back at quarterback. Looking downfield. He's going to throw it for the sideline. Oh, Hunter Miller! No, they're going to say incomplete. Oh, he almost made a shoe-top grab. Broke to the inside and made a diving effort at the ball. And he actually corralled it, but it hit the ground before he could reel it all the way in.
What a great read. Change of direction, got in behind the defender. The defender never turned around to see the ball. Cut back behind him. Blocked.
They're thinking about calling the play here. Under a minute to go here in the third quarter. Fourth and 10. Ball on the 45-yard line.
Yeah, good.
We're going to look for it down the middle of the field. Picked off! Racing for the sideline. Grady Hunt trying to bottle him up. Oh, another good block. Kalari's going to reel him in.
So a big pick there by Maynard. Ball returned down to the Littleton 15-yard line. So Littleton going for it on fourth down. And they throw a pick. And the Maynard defense, again, making a huge contribution.
Looked like, there was a little miscommunication on what that route was supposed to be. The receivers actually never turned around on that one. I think somebody's supposed to break off the tackle, but Jarrett to save a touchdown here, see if they can stop him.
45 seconds to go in the third quarter. Ball returned all the way down to the Littleton 15-yard line. So two turnovers on the last two possessions by Littleton. Puts him in the hole. Inside handoff. Got a 5-yard gain. He's powering forward. He's all the way down to about the 5-yard line. It's close to a first down. So again, with that run up the middle, Maynard really making some hay out of that look. Second and one. Ball just outside on the 6-yard line.
On the 6, Mike.
Yeah, second down, another inside handoff, stacked up. He's going to pick up, I think he's going to pick up the first down. If he gets to the 5-yard line, he'll have a first down. Yeah, it's going to be first and goal from the 5-yard line, but that's going to end the quarter. So Littleton with two turnovers on the last two possessions, Maynard scoring on a fumble return for a touchdown on the first turnover, and now knocking on the door after the second turnover. Littleton trailing 12-6 at the end of the third quarter. We'll be back with the end of the game, or the remaining quarter, right after these messages. Welcome back to the fourth quarter. Tigers trailing 12-6 against Maynard here on the road. Maynard first and goal on the 5-yard line to start the fourth quarter after the second consecutive Littleton turnover.
See what they have here, Mike. See if Mike Lynn can get those linemen to get some penetration here. Get in.
Straight up the middle.
There you go.
He's going to get hit. He's still not down. The Tigers' pursuit of the point of contact going to be about a 3-yard gain down to the 2-yard line. So they did a better job there, but it's still positive yardage for Maynard.
Yep.
Second and goal, the ball at about the 1.5-yard line. See if they send a blitz or shoot a gap here. Counter handoff.
Good penetration.
Touchdown. Wasn't a much of a game, but they didn't need much, and they got what they needed to hit pay dirt. So they'll go up 18-6 here. They tried two kicks here, and one was wide, had plenty of leg, but wide, and the second one was blocked.
One of the hard things here, Mike, is the way this game's been going, Littleton's probably only looking at two more possessions, right, in a game like this.
Well, they're going to definitely have to think about airing the ball out. Yeah, Maynard's going to go after going 0-for-2 on the kicks. They're going to try and convert here from the play from scrimmage. They're going to do an unbalanced lineup. Oh, great play there. Eric Walker took an aggressive line from his linebacker position. And once the quarterback got outside of him, it was an easy run to the goal line. So Tigers trail by 14, 20-6, with 10:05 to go here early in the fourth quarter. You're right, Pat, though. You know, they just right now down two scores. They really don't have the luxury of trying to grind another 5.5 minute drive out. I think they're going to have to, you don't have to throw it on every down, but you're going to have to try to bite off bigger chunks of yardage. And that probably means they're going to have to go to the spread and stay with it no matter how it goes for them.
Yep. You know, the other thing, too, is defensively, they're going to need to make a pretty, next time Vader gets the ball, they're going to have to make a pretty quick stop on that. They're going to have to get three and out or maybe one first down, but see if Littleton can't break something here, though. Anthony Ross would be Bradley Clark.
Yeah, you're right. Even if they do score, they can't afford to give up a long drive. But more importantly, at this point, the defense has to be thinking they got to pitch a shutout from the rest of the way here.
Yeah.
You know, they had a terrific opening drive to start the half, tied the game up. And then, unfortunately, they had two turnovers in the next two drives.
Sliding a couple of their good runners back. Rocker drops back. Ball's generally been hitting on the 25, 30-yard line.
Another high kick that's going to be fielded by Lanfers. They're going to power forward at about the 39-yard line. So let's see how the Tigers come out here. Trailing by 14. 10:01 to go in the ball game. And they're going to go spread, but looks like Kalari's going to play quarterback. Yeah, Jared Kalari playing quarterback in the spread for the first time this year. So there's definitely Griffin Shoemaker. Something is bothering him. It's not obvious because he's not limping and he played on the last set of downs. But trailing by 14, they're going to go with their backup spread quarterback. Kalari, incomplete pass on that down. Second and 10.
Jared's a really good second option here. Throws a good ball. Smart kid.
Screen pass. Oh. Maynard diagnosed it, and he couldn't get the throw off, and he takes a big sack there, 10-yard sack back down to the 30-yard line. That was a designed screenplay, but the defensive lineman read it and got into the flat, so Jared wasn't comfortable making the throw, and then you let the pressure in on purpose. That's the idea. The safety valve is supposed to be thrown over the screen as a safety valve against that pressure, but he couldn't get it off. Third and 20. Fumble snap, picks it up. Gonna get hit again.
Michael's last two plays, they were tough for Jared, but I gotta tell you, not the last play to play before that. He actually made a really good decision in not throwing that ball. You know, we'll be able to punt the ball here or go for it, but I think if Jared had thrown that ball two plays ago, then it might have been picked off. So it didn't look the greatest, but good decision by Jared anyway.
Yeah, tough one. That both those plays, he really didn't have any kind of options there, and he's had to take the punishment. So tough start there on that series of downs, and a punt fielded on the 40-yard line, a line shot over midfield. Sawyer Lanford's on the tackle, so Maynard will take over in Littleton territory, ball in about the 48-yard line. So big pressure on the defense here, Pat. They've really got to force a three and out here. And even then, Maynard will have a chance to pin Littleton down.
Yeah, one play at a time, right? Three and out here?
Yeah.
And get the ball back?
Yep. That's, take care of one thing at a time. Getting the ball back is important. Let's start on first down here and see if they can force Maynard into get a couple stops and force him to a long yardage situation. Maynard adjusting after the first few series of downs. The Tiger defense wasn't giving up much of anything. Maynard found a recipe that's working, those inside counter handoffs. Up the middle that time. Oh, they missed him. They had him and they missed him. It could be a 6-yard game. The Tigers gambling. They had 9 guys up on the box that time, taking some chances. They had a hit at the line of scrimmage, but they couldn't finish it off. And it actually turned into a 7-yard game. Second and 3, the ball on the Littleton 39-yard line.
Littleton's got to be a little careful here. They get a little over anxious on that line. I know they want to get in there, but that last play was actually pretty close to being offside.
their handoff. And again, they hit him in the backfield, and they can't wrap him up, and he's going to power forward for a first down.
Now it's Longo on a great run.
So that'll be first and 10 with the ball at the Tiger 35-yard line. Clock winding, under 8 minutes to go, 7:45.
First and 10 from the Littleton 35.
It is gut check time.
Back again in that counter handoff. You get about a 2 yard gain. Coming up on 7 minutes to go in the ball game.
And Maynard here is content to let this clock run down every play.
Yeah, at some point, Mike Lynn's going to have to think about burning those timeouts. You can control the clock when you have the ball. You can't control it when you don't have the ball. Down to, if you're down a score, that's one thing, but down two scores, the clock becomes as big a factor as the actual score does. Sweep.
We get him from behind.
Rocker's trying to strip the ball from behind, and we couldn't quite get it. Short of the first down, but again, a chance for a hit for a loss.
And Rocker is holding his shoulder. I know that he missed last week because of a hit he took to his shoulder in practice. He looks like he's hurting right now.
Third and two, four downs all the way here for Maynard based on the field position.
Now if Eric had just one more step, I think we would have seen that ball come out.
Yeah, I would have liked to see him take a swipe at it, get a chance to take a swipe at it. He just couldn't quite close where he wanted. He had designs on it, but big effort from the backside. Third and two.
6 minutes remaining in the game.
Inside handoff. First down. Yep, he's over the 25 yard line. That's good for a big first down. That's a significant first down for them. Really puts them in the driver's seat. They're going to get to use four more downs here with the clock under 6 minutes to go.
They need somebody to strip a ball here, Mike.
Yeah, they got to take some chances, send some blitzes, and you're right, got to go for the strip. Ball on the 24-yard line, first and 10 for Maynard. Inside handoff again, positive yards. Ball down to the 15-yard line. So very close to a first down, about a 9-yard gain. So Maynard just winning the battle up front right now.
So McCullough picks up 8 yards, second and two.
Maynard running backs are doing an excellent job of just letting the play develop and then hitting the holes quicker than Littleton can get there.
Yeah, and the offensive line's doing a nice job of creating some running lanes there. They've got to hold those blocks. Those are slow-developing plays, but they've really done a good job here in the second half and the scoring drive in the first half. Oh, blitz that time. Rocker gets in there. It's going to go for a loss. Yeah, Rocker's definitely gimped up. He's trying to get up, he's grabbing and holding his shoulder.
Official timeout. He's with Rocker.
I have a problem with this. You know, I know that the ref's concerned about player safety and everything, but Eric was getting up off the ground, and the ref's going to make him take a play off. He's a ref, not a doctor. All right, third and two.
For Rocker. Chance to make something happen.
Oh, good job there. Short of the first down. Mitch Corey coming in from linebacker. Rocker coming right back out on the field. So that's one thing, it's useless. It's, you know, Rocker's going to make, and the coaching staff are going to make their own decisions about whether he can play. The ref doesn't need to insert himself. It would be one thing if he literally didn't get up for a few seconds, but. All right, big down here, fourth down. under 4 minutes to go. Fourth and really about a yard. If Maynard can convert here, they probably can think about running the clock out unless, and actually what they're going to do is let the play clock run down and then they're going to take a timeout. So with 3:26, they'll take the timeout here. Clock is definitely on their side. If they convert here, the clock will actually be there's nothing really the Tigers can do. I mean, they can burn their timeouts, but down two scores.
I can't even remember the last time we thought that Littleton was down two scores or made that statement.
Yeah, even last year when they they lost to West Boston in the playoffs, so, it was a really close game. And that turned out to be their only loss last year. It was just that one loss in the playoffs. Well, we knew it. Maynard off to a great start, and Littleton off to a great start. We knew that this was going to be a big matchup. It's still early in the year, but we talked at the top of the telecast how this game, this matchup, would have significant implications on the playoff situation, and it would clearly put Maynard in the driver's seat. They'll have gotten past what they surely would consider, one of their two stiffest tests on their schedule, West Boylston being the other one. And, Maynard, West Boylston, Littleton all circling each other, very good Central Mass teams, but all, more importantly, all in the same conference. They're all going to play each other once before the playoffs start. So Maynard is going to get on the top of that, and Littleton will be in a kind of a must-win situation against West Boylston a few weeks from now. Fourth down. Inside handoff, he's not going to get it. So the Tigers will stop him and get the ball back with 3:20 to go, trailing by 14 points. So the defense did what they could there to give him a couple of first downs, but finally got the stop they needed to take the ball over on downs with the ball on their own. Looks like it's going to be right on the 16-yard line.
Now, Mike, if you're Littleton, you want this game to happen early in the season as well, right? You don't want to be playing in Maynard or West Boylston at the end of the season and then try to have to figure out what it is that you need to do. So games like this, if they're going to happen, you want it to come early in the season.
And I think, one loss, they'll clearly get in the playoffs. Two losses, they probably will have a very good chance to get in the playoffs. So, don't want to lose the ball game, and it's a great rivalry. You always want to beat Maynard. Maynard's going to feel like they really did something tonight, and they should feel that way. But Littleton's got to feel like, hey, you're going to say, we're just going to go figure this out and come back hammer here. And then just try to go take care of business in the rest of the ball games, and looking forward to that big matchup with West Boylston.
Right.
Next week they are back on the road as they travel all the way out to Winchendon to play Murdoch. And then they are back home on October 7th versus Clinton. So those are two games that they would expect to put in the win column.
Picks up about 2 yards.
So second and 8 here. Now they're going to go spread. Yep, timeout. Maynard, they actually got confused for a minute. They saw the hammer look, and then all of a sudden Littleton comes out in the spread. They didn't quite have the package they wanted out there to defend that.
I might try to take a shot at one of these edges here, give either Hunter Miller or Jackson Ellis a chance to make a play.
Yeah, it's kind of what the only option that they have left. They need some blocking up front, though, to give Kalari some time to look downfield and let those guys get into that deep route. The last two passing plays, he was under tremendous pressure.
Quick score here, though. A quick score, and then anything's open.
A roll to his right. Lob it down the sideline, looking for Rossa. And a terrific athletic play there by the defensive back. Ronnie McCormick on the play. Just jumped up and spiked that ball to the ground. That'll bring up third and 7. 3:02 left to go in the ball game here. The ball on the Littleton 19-yard line. You need to get to about the over the 26-yard line here to pick up a first down. Staying in the spread. Lodge it down the middle of the field. Jackson Ellis over the top. Couldn't quite reel it in. Good throw by Kalari, but just a little high.
Fourth down. Well, Littleton on their own 19.
They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Nothing to lose. Trail by 14.
Put it up again. There's definitely some routes that are open here, Mike.
Oh, Cam Shoemaker's. Throw this one over the middle. Jackson Ellis again. Couldn't make the catch. So the Tigers will turn the ball back over on downs. Couldn't get anything going on that series. Get the ball back on the 19-yard line, and that's probably going to pretty much determine the outcome of the game, Pat.
Yeah, overall, not a bad, poorly played game for Littleton. I think, you know, they didn't put the ball in the end zone a lot. It was that one turnover that turned into a touchdown. That was kind of a game breaker for them.
Yeah, I mean, the second turnover was on a fourth down and 10. You know, they weren't going to get the first down, so they were going to give the ball up anyway. So it wasn't as obvious that that was a problem. But you're right, that fumble return for a touchdown was big, especially after, they had scored. They had forced a three and out, and then they gave a big play there that kind of turned the tide. And they just couldn't get back in the ball game after that. That's Corey with a big hit there. A short gain by Maynard.
On the carry. Mitch Corey on the stop. Dazone picks up about 2 yards. Down to the Littleton 17.
And obviously, you know, not having Griffin Shoemaker at full strength in the second half in a game where you're trailing, you know, definitely one of the best players, one of the biggest playmakers that we have. And he just didn't get on track. He almost popped a couple in the first half, and then we just didn't have a chance to see what he could do in the second half. We'll have to find out later exactly what that was all about. Hopefully he'll be back next week at full strength.
Yeah, we saw a couple of kids on the sideline. Not that that's an excuse, but, you know, you have to figure out how to play without kids. And that's another thing you take out of here. You know, what are we going to do when Griffin's not in the game? What are we going to do when Frizzoli's not around in the game? Try to adjust a little bit and work from that.
All right, so third down here, under 2 minutes to go. The clock is running. At some point here, the Maynard could think about just taking a couple of knees. They got two downs here in this series of them. They can't quite do it yet. They pick up a first down to be able to run the clock out if Littleton decides not to burn their timeouts, which doesn't look like they're going to do.
1:30 remaining in the game.
Gonna go sweep. Oh, great job there by Rocker. Got off his blocker and made a hit there. Now Littleton will call a timeout.
I like this, Mike. Play the whistle.
Littleton timeout. We got fourth and about six. Ball on the 15-yard line. 1:19 to go in the ball game. Tigers down by 14.
So as we get this timeout, you know, and I'm thinking back on the game, I guess the old word that comes to mind is it was just kind of a quiet game for Littleton, right? No big plays. They got off to an early start. I thought they looked really good at the beginning of the game. And I thought they were going to kind of have their way, and Maynard just kind of bottled it up. And from the time that they had that run here at midfield when Griffin had the open field, right after that, it's been pretty quiet.
Yeah, they definitely struggled in the spread. They couldn't really get the look. They couldn't run or throw out of it effectively. And they more or less abandoned it and went to the hammer. And they were good in the hammer. They had a great drive to tie the game up at the opening of the second half. But then after the turnovers, you get in the hole. And at that point, you don't have the luxury of running that offense. You got to go to the spread. But without Griffin, it was harder to run. They definitely struggled offensively. Defensively, it was actually a good game. I remember one score was a defensive touchdown, and the last score was almost a defensive touchdown in the sense that they got the ball down to the 15-yard line, and they managed to score from there. So, I think they're going to look at the film. They're going to realize there were some missed tackles that they would like to clean up. But overall, they certainly weren't out-muscled by Maynard. Maynard did find a recipe that worked for them, that inside counter handoff game really worked very well for them, and they rode it to a victory here. But, you know, if these guys do match up back in the playoffs, which is entirely possible, there's no reason to feel like Littleton's an underdog in that game.
Yeah, I would agree with that 100%. And, if they do match up again, Mike's going to have plenty of time to look at that game film. Stop that inside handoff. I kind of hope they match up again. It'd be a good game to watch at the very least.
Fourth down, they're going to throw.
From behind.
Pressure from the backside. He's going to throw it out of bounds. So the Tigers will take over on downs again with a minute and 12 to go, trailing by 14. Let's see if they run some plays.
1:12 remaining in the game. Littleton will take it over first and 10.
And I would. They got to go downfield. There's nothing to.
From there, 15.
All right, so they will put Kalari back at quarterback. Spread look.
Mike's got some timeouts here, too. You know, you might want to try to run some, just for the sake of running some underneath routes, see how that goes, get some practice. There you go.
Good throw up the middle. Oh, good break on the ball there by McCormick. He made some good plays there in the defensive backfield.
Powers pass. Knocked down by Ryan McCormick. Second and 10.
Jared's throwing the ball very well out of this.
Yeah, he did some good-looking balls. Just hasn't quite completed them with his receivers yet. But low snap, handoff to Lanfers. Tackled after a short game. Coming up on a minute to go in the ball game.
Yeah, you make a good point, too, Mike. Part of this just might be timing. You know, receivers are running their routes. They need to complete them and turn around. And you know, Jared's back there. They might not, you know, not seeing Griffin back there. Might be throwing him off just a little bit. But we'll get over that pretty quickly. Shows a good tight ball.
Littleton will take a timeout here on 3rd and 10. 58 seconds left to go in the ball game. You know, it would have been nice to see if they could have, you know, gotten a one more drive going and cut it to, you know, a one-score game with and get a conversion and then maybe go for an onside kick. But the Maynard did what they had to do. They got a drive going two possessions before this where they had good field position. They picked up two first downs, and that really let the clock run and really didn't give Littleton any kind of realistic opportunity to take. Like you said, Pat, they just didn't get enough possessions. Especially, you know, they've been a little inefficient tonight in the passing game, and they needed a few more to really see if they could get something going.
Yeah.
Throw to the sideline. Hunter Miller makes the catch, and he's out of bounds. After a gain, it'll bring up fourth down and about four. The ball out over the 20-yard line. 52 seconds to go.
Hunter Miller.
Yeah, this is a perfectly good example of what you want to be doing here, right? Run a route that's going to give you guys an excellent chance of getting the first down here and keeping this going. Executing with under a minute to go.
Fourth and four. Good blocking up front. Kalari gives a good throw there to Eric Rocker. Reels in, does the right thing, goes out of bounds. They pick up a first down, 44 seconds to go. That'll move the chains to about the 29-yard line. Actually, the 27-yard line. First and 10, 44 seconds left to go in the game. A couple completions in a row by Kalari. Low snap again. Rolling to his right, buy some time up. Oh, the ball fell out of his hand and goes out of bounds. Are they going to call that? I think that's a fumble. Yeah, they're going to mark it out. No, he's going to say it's an incomplete pass. His arm is going forward. So that'll just go down as an incomplete pass.
A little pump fake there, and the ball just slipped out. A little hard to hold the ball.
Yeah. So incomplete pass, 37 seconds. Second and 10. Good blocking up front. Kalari's going up for Jackson Ellis. Makes a leaping attempt at the ball and glances off his hands downfield. Incomplete, third and 10.
I like that drill by Jared. Put it up there. Jackson's got a little bit of a height advantage. Let him go up and try to make a play.
Screen pass to Rocker. Rossa gonna head for the sideline. Hurdles one guy. Oh, go out of bounds. Gonna pick up a first down there, but the ball's in bounds. They'll stop the clock long enough to move the chains. Ball out to the
spike here.
Yeah, 44-yard line. 18 seconds to go. Tigers are going to get under the center. They're going to go quick snap, spike the ball, stop the clock. So with 14 seconds to go, they pick up a first down on the previous play. And they will have second and 10 from their own 44-yard line.
Pitch fake, second and 10 for Littleton, stopping the clock with 11 seconds remaining in the game.
Double throw here, that's a lateral. Nope, you're gonna run it. Ross is trying to make something out. It's gonna go down. That'll be the last play of the game. So, a big Central Mass matchup between the Tigers. It's the Maynard Tigers who come on top for the first time in a long time in a football game against Littleton. Maynard with a hard-earned win. Early in the season, Pat, it wouldn't surprise me if we see these two teams circling each other towards the playoffs. We'll see how the rest of the season plays off. Five more games to go before the playoff seedings are determined.
When we looked at that schedule at the beginning of the year, we were thinking the Maynard game, the West Boylston game would boom large, and certainly panned out to be that way. And well, this would be a good challenge for Littleton. Go back, regroup, come out, got a couple of good games facing you in the next couple of weeks, and let's see how they come out.
All right, so that's the ball game. The Tigers on the short end of a 20-6 score against the rival, the Maynard Tigers. And that'll be it for us for LCTV. Me, Pat Fredrickson, and Mark Crory on the crew tonight. And we'll be back in a couple of weeks at home against Clinton on October 7th. See you then.